So, as you know that the GATE exam is over, and I hope that you people have done well in the exam. So, in this video, I'm just going to give a quick review. This is gonna be a very short video, okay? This is like a very quick review of the paper because I don't exactly remember many questions of the paper. But I talked to many people and myself, I felt that this paper was quite different from previous year's papers. This time, numerical answer type questions were more okay, what I felt, and also that you can't say that question paper was like unpredictable. It was predictable, you can predict the questions because most of the questions were like you got questions from that bioinorganic, okay, that was also a very good question. Then you got questions from weight rule, okay, and lots of numericals you got from that chemical kinetics and electrochemistry. So what I have felt that if you are good in physical chemistry, if anybody has solved more numericals and he has concentrated more on physical chemistry, which I usually do, and if you have followed my videos, I usually solve physical chemistry questions with like solutions and with explanation. So physical questions are, if you have done physical question, it would be helped you in this exam, okay. And few of the questions, like that aptitude part, that part was also very nice, okay. You can easily score good marks in that, like around from that you can easily score like 12 to 13 marks you can easily get from that aptitude part, okay. So few questions which I remember from aptitude part, one of was like that it was given that the area of a triangle was root 3 and you have to find out the perimeter. So perimeter of the triangle, it would be 6, okay. So how it would have happened, because for equilateral triangle the area formula is root 3 upon 4 side square, and it was given root 3. So side square value will become root 3 into 4 upon root 3. So these root 3 will cancel out and side value will be like you can take under root of 4, it will become plus minus 2 and you have to take only plus 2. So for perimeter formula is 3 into 2, so it would be 6, okay. So 6 was the correct answer. Then again one question also came from aptitude part which I felt was very difficult. That was it was given that you are having 4 parallel lines, okay, 4 parallel lines and 5 parallel lines. So after intersecting, how many parallelograms you must have got. So for that question, you have to follow this equation, that 4c2, this formula, okay, 4c2 into 5c2. This is basically from combination question, okay. And it was like you would have got 4 factorial upon 2 factorial into 2 factorial into 5 factorial upon 2 factorial into 3 factorial. So I'm doing here only all these things, okay. I'm not like, say it will be 4 into 3 into 2 into 2 factorial upon 2 factorial into 2 into 1 into 5 into 5 into 4 into 3 factorial upon 3 factorial into 2. So 5 to 10, and it would have given you 3 to 6, so 10 into 6 is equals to 60. So 60 was the correct answer for that question, okay, for parallel line question. Now these were from aptitude which I remember, and one more question was there that sine and cos function, they were asked that in which interval they are decreasing. If I remember exactly, that answer was pi by 2 to pi, okay, because if you know what sine graph is, so for sine it graph goes like this, okay. It is 0, it is pi by 2, it is pi, okay. And for cos the graph goes like this, okay. So this is pi by 2 and this is pi. So in this interval only, pi by 2 to pi, this is function is also decreasing and this function is also decreasing. For this, so I use this concept to solve this, or it would have been solved from that maximum minima, if you know, like that is very deep. If you know that much mathematics, then you would have done with that also. So that aptitude part was easy, okay, what I felt. English was also very easy. Okay, that two questions came on English. They were like very easy. Then coming to the chemistry part, some of the question which I remember, one question that came on weight rule, that was very good question. That it was given like B5H8, if I remember exactly. Okay, so if you have seen my videos which I have made on like on that where I have used a carborane, okay, and that there I have told that what how you have to exchange. But like here what you can do, okay, for one minus charge you can use one more hydrogen, okay, to replace one hydrogen, one minus charge with one hydrogen. So it would have, or one, I will tell you two methods, okay, to do that. If you have done like that, then it would have become B5H9, okay. Or you can also do like this, that you can remove three hydrogens. If you remove three hydrogens, you have to increase the charges. So one charge is already here and three more charges, then it would have become B5H5 and 4 minus. In both the cases, it is like BnHn plus 4. Okay, so for n plus 4, it is NEDO. So answer was NEDO over here. Okay, and one more question came from 2 plus 2 cycloaddition. That was like, this question was like that. Okay, something like that. Okay, so for this question it was given that H nu. So in conditions, you have to give 2 plus 2 cycloaddition, and the product would be like somewhat like this. So okay, so this was the answer. So these are the some of the question which I remember. One more question was there in which ground state term symbol it was asked. Okay, for I think it was like COH2 whole 6 2 plus and COCl whole 4 2 minus. This was the question. I don't remember exactly, but somewhat it was like that. Only the answer was what I remember is 4 T2G and like 4A2, something like this it was. Okay, so see, I'm waiting for the questions to be uploaded on the official website. When questions will be uploaded on the official website, I will solve them like with proper explanation. Okay, and coming back to the cutoff, which you all must be asking, that what is the going to be the cutoff. So I won't say the cutoff will increase from the previous one. Previous I think it was 25 marks, so it won't increase by then, because you know what, in this exam lots of numericals were asked, and chemistry students don't practice that much numerical. I'm not telling about everyone, but most of the students, they believe in inorganic chemistry and organic chemistry basically. So they like, for them the paper was quite difficult. Okay, so I would say the cutoff will go like that only, around 23 to 25 marks it would go. It won't go beyond 25, okay, what I think. And let's hope for the best, and let's see what. And coming back to that, what I'm going to do next, so I will be giving videos for June 2018, okay, CSIR exam. For June 2018 CSIR exam, I will be posting videos topic wise, okay. So stay tuned to us, and if you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe it. And okay, so wish you all the best. That's it. So thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe the video, and all the best for your results. Okay, thank you.